Vedali from the International Institute of Knowledge Management. I'm a big fan of this body, and today unfortunately the conference appeared to be a bit smaller than normal. But these guys organize 24 to 30 conferences a year, tourism being one of them. And it's a great success story. I mean, they were both, Aujali and Isaka, the two partners, they were students at the University of Jayawardena some years, 2 years back, and they were specializing in marketing. And end of the term, project was to organize a symposium and, you know, get the participants. And the project was so successful, their professors said, you know, you guys should give this a try, you know, maybe make it a career. And they took that advice, they never worked for anyone. They started this company, and today they organize 25 conferences a year, international conferences, including in other cities like they had one in Bangkok, and they are organizing one in Vietnam and other countries. So it's an amazing company. Thank you very much. A warm welcome again to this beautiful country at this brand new hotel. It's opened by the Minister of Tourism a few months ago this year. And just to focus on our keywords at this conference, we are obviously talking about tourism and hospitality management. We are discussing things around the world. We couple of other keywords. We were particularly looking for industry and academic collaborations. It doesn't happen all the time, but that was sort of our focus. And we are looking for innovation, sharing innovative best practices, and also futuristic sort of ideas. So that's what we are trying to do. The program itself, which is in front of you, has 8 technical sessions and 4 other sessions. Although the participation is about a couple of dozens, I think it is a very rich conference in terms of what we are going to share during the next 2 days. So I wish you all the best. I want to tell you a little story. I see a lot of people have come from sort of developing countries in this conference. I remember in 1983, having been a local hotelier in Sri Lanka, I decided to have an international career. I realized that I have to get some internationally recognized qualifications, and I decided to go to Jayawardena. I joined the University of Surrey in Gilbert, which is at that time the best university for tourism and hospitality education. I did a master's degree. My focus at that time wasn't exactly tourism, the macro thing, but more micro, hotel management. I want to be international 5-star GM. I want to get an education to help me to achieve that target. And also I want to do research to help me to achieve that target. So I finished all the 10 modules of this master's program by 84. Then of course there was 6 months time to write a dissertation or a thesis. We were bouncing ideas with my professors in England, what I should be writing. They said, okay, most of them are tourism experts. So they said, you are from South Asia, why don't you write a paper on a thesis on tourism forecasting and trends in South Asia. I wasn't interested at that time. I'm interested on that topic now, but at that time that wasn't my goal. I said, no, I want to write on something on food and beverage management. They said, oh, that doesn't sound very academic, you know, catering and food and beverage. I said, that's what I want to do. I want to be a food and beverage director of a 5-star hotel, then become assistant general manager, then become GM. That was my career plan. They didn't like it. They said, no, we are a top university here, we should be writing about tourism. I said, no, I am in the micro business. So anyway, because I was so pushy, they said, okay, do 3 pages, explain what you are going to write. So I wrote 3 pages saying, I was very nervous because my English wasn't very good. I mean, in Sri Lanka, I went to a predominant Buddhist in the school with 6,000 students. We never spoke English at school. So I was a bit nervous. My command of the language wasn't great, but you know, I sort of managed well in the UK. And writing the thesis was a bit of a challenge. So I didn't want, on top of being challenged by the language, the linguistic challenges. I didn't want to embark on an area that I had no expertise. I would write for something that I was spending. I mean, exactly shared and things like that. So food and beverage was very close to me. Then I wrote this 3-page proposal. I said, I will work and research on all 60 five-star hotels. There were 21 five-star hotels in the UK, 16 of them were in London. I said, I will work in all 21 five-star hotels, get experience, interview all the general managers, executive chefs, food and beverage directors, read everything ever written on the subject of food and beverage management in English, in USA, States, Australia, etc., Canada. And then write the proposal. It's okay. You go ahead with it. And my one well-known writer and professor there, Professor Richard Kotas, agreed to be my supervisor. But he said, you know, 4 of you is too much of a sample size. Why don't you focus on London? You live in London, just focus on London. So I actually, next 6 months, I worked very hard. I went to all the 16 five-star hotels. They did observation period, some of the places I worked. It did happen, 60 interviews, read every English literature ever written on the subject and wrote a massive thesis because I had a passion on the subject. It was helping me in my career. My professor hated me for writing such a long thing. I actually wrote 350 pages, it was 100,000 words. It's bigger than most of the PhD thesis. And he hated me for doing this, but he had to correct my English and check everything, but he was impressed. And then he said, Chandi, this is some amazing work. You should publish it. I need a heart attack, you know. I said, publish? This is my second language and I don't write. But he said, no, I will be your co-author. And we, so he co-authored, I got into publishing with that. And so I was simply nervous then it was published by Hotter and Southern, one of the top publishing houses in England. He said, go down, meet the people, meet the publishers. I went there one day to the big building, and so I was very apologetic. I told my managing editor of the series that, you know, my English is not very good, so I'm very nervous. She took me to the 7th floor, showed me a floor of hunt. At that time, everything was done in the UK. Now everything is outsourced to other parts of the world. She showed me a floor with about 100 people working there. She said, do you know something? Do you know what they are doing? They are our proofreaders. They are excellent proofreaders. So don't worry about your lack of knowledge in the English language. We are giving you a contract for your ideas and your knowledge. So I thought, oh, I got popular business. Anyway, we published that book, and because of my co-author's reputation, it became a standard textbook for British universities and colleges for a long time, and I made this money as well. Then I started publishing, and I said, okay, this is a good thing to do. But my lesson there is that when people do research, do something close to your heart, something that helps you in your career. And when you are a professor, most of your professors think like that about your students. You know, it should be something useful, interesting, not only to supervise about the students. And the second lesson is collaborate. We are here with the international community. I think about 15 countries are represented here. Some of us don't write very well in English, but you can get contacts. You can collaborate with people whose first language is English, whether they are from UK or USA or Canada, they are in Australia. You can collaborate. That's the power of research. So I have over the last, this big journey that I had in publishing and writing, from humble beginning I published 19 books and over 110 articles. About 60% of them are collaborative work. You know, so I come with the idea. I still remember when I worked in the University of West Indies in Jamaica, the first regional university in the world, about 50,000 students. They have campuses, key campuses in 4 of the Caribbean countries. They have small campuses in 17 countries. It's owned by 17 governments in the Caribbean, and it's the first regional university. It started as a university college of the University of London 60 years ago. And when I joined the faculty as a senior lecturer and the leader for the for smart cities, green tourism and hospitality, I started writing a lot for the Caribbean. And every time I wrote an article, I took 24 copies of the draft, did a little walk in the corridor. There were 24 PhDs who were my colleagues, who were from Harvard, from Yale, from Oxford, from Cambridge, everywhere. In fields other than mine, mine was tourism now, but they are economists and financial people. I printed 24 copies of my draft article, gave it to each person. No one else did it, because they keep their research very close to their heart. I made 24 copies, gave it to everybody, I said the same story, even English is my second language, can you please read it and give me some comments? Most of them won't contribute, they will give comments. So it enhances my paper. So don't feel shy to share your work with your colleagues from other disciplines. We can do that, it's even great research, even if you look at the, read the biography of people like Bernard Shaw, the great playwright. Every time he wrote a story, including My Fair Lady or whatever, he showed it to his maid, housekeeper. He made copies, the readings. Give your comments, because he was not connected to the common person. He was a made out of money from his writing. He got it reviewed by uneducated people, but who had a connection to his audience. And he get coming. So don't feel shy to collaborate, get views from people who are may not be subject specialists. It enhances your work. So this conference is small. We want to do a couple of things to make revive this. I remember the first or second one, we had about 140 participants from 30 countries. So it was fifth year, it has come down a little bit. But we want to revive this. Next year the organizers have agreed we will probably have it in another city and maybe make it two conferences. Because this conference, in my view as a former hotelier, I know it attracts a lot of tourism experts. But it doesn't attract enough hoteliers, hospitality people, and the local, many locals. So for that reason, we want to do a couple of deals with the local associations. And concurrently have this conference again, sixth time next year. At the same time, introduce a new conference in the International Conference of Hotel Management. Make it open for other people. And probably have sort of some overlapping sessions, so both conferences will benefit from that. That's our sort of a plan for the next year. I hope you will tell your colleagues from the other sectors that the organizers are thinking of doing this. End of the day, we want you to this to be a useful conference, an interesting conference, and where you will find some benefits for you, personal benefits. So one thing I can mention as the head of a forthcoming issue in the worldwide tourism and hospitality trends, we have a dedicated issue to be published in England as an e-journal by January 2019. So best papers from this conference, your papers will anyway get published in the conference proceedings, but my proposal is that the better ones who fit into that that journal's theme, which is looking at worldwide innovation in tourism, best practices type of thing, I will be talking with you, please talk with me, and I will sort of give the guidelines. We want to get my aim as editor of that to get about 14 to 15 case studies from 15 countries. Not very long, about 3,000 word case studies. Ideally, papers written by academics with input from the industry leaders looking at innovative practices. We don't want to have two papers from the same country, one per country. Later, if you're interested, please come to the session on publishing this afternoon, which I will be sort of sharing or reviewing. So look forward to talking with you. It's small, but I think we have to make sure this quality is good and that you are all benefited from this conference. Have a great conference. Thank you for coming.